Hello, world. This is Lisa Fredrickson, your friend and computer science professor from Johnson County Community College, welcoming you to 2020 and Web 114 JavaScript 1. If you're watching this YouTube, you're probably in my JavaScript 1 class, and I thought it was appropriate to welcome you and also just touch upon some of the prerequisite knowledge that I want you to be solid on to succeed in Web 114 JavaScript 1. And that prerequisite knowledge comes from Web 110, HTML and CSS. First of all, it's extremely important that you have some terminology under your belt before you go into JavaScript, because we're going to be learning a lot of new keywords, and some of them depend on your previous knowledge of HTML and CSS. For HTML, the terms element and attribute should be solid. If we look at some HTML code, we know that HTML elements are in blue in Notepad++, and the attributes go in the opening tag and further define the element. So the attributes in Notepad++ are in red, and we know that we have elements for structure, the head section and the body section, the two major sections of the HTML document. In the head section, we see several elements. Some are empty. In other words, they only have an opening tag. They don't have a closing tag. Some are paired, such as the title. I have an embedded style sheet here in the head section. And then in the body section, I've got several elements, an outer wrapper div so that I can style the div and the content differently than the body, which goes wall to wall from one side of the screen to the other. I've got an H1 element, an unordered list, some list items, an unordered list inside the list item, and an H2 element. Two key attributes that we will be using in JavaScript are the ID attribute and the class attribute. And you should know by now that the ID attribute is used to uniquely identify our particular HTML element. So if we want to talk to that element with JavaScript to change it in response to a user clicking on a page or entering something in an input box, we need to be able to identify that element, and we typically do that through the ID attribute. The class attribute is also used a lot in JavaScript, and it's used in the same way it's typically used in HTML, and that is to change styles based on changing classes. Right now, I have classes, an HTML class and a CSS class, and if we go up to our style sheet, we see that we address those classes in our style sheet, in our CSS, with the period, the dot, and so for anything in the HTML class, I'm going to make the color blue. For anything in the CSS class, I'm going to make the color, text color, red. Here's how I address an ID attribute value, pound sign, or the hashtag. And I've got these rules for that. And then here I'm just working with an individual HTML element. There's no special character, no dot for the class, or no pound sign for the ID. Element and attribute, those are your two key pieces of HTML terminology you should be completely comfortable with. In CSS, there are three terms that you need to be comfortable with. Selector, and the selector can address an ID. It can address a class where there are many elements in the same class together, or it can address an individual HTML element. So all the UL in this document will have a 1M bottom margin. And how many ULs do I have? 1, 2. Then the other two key terms in CSS are the properties, and anything before this colon is a property. That's what we're changing, followed by the colon, followed by the property value. When you put the property colon and the property value and the trailing semicolon all together, that's called a declaration. Its nickname is a style. Its true name is the declaration. So in summary, there are two HTML terms that you must know going into JavaScript 1. What is an HTML element and what is an attribute? And for CSS, you need to know what is a selector, the property, and then the full style or the declaration. Of course, the other basic things that are important to the class are what is the textbook. We're going to be using an online free javascript.info. I talk a lot more about that in my upcoming YouTube. You're going to need a code editor. I'm using Notepad++, but you might prefer Brackets, Visual Studio Code, Text Wrangler. Whatever you're comfortable with, I'm comfortable with, as long as it's got good color coding. I also want you to check Canvas frequently. I recommend 3 times a week at least. You know how to publish to the JCCC student web server, or if you use the cPanel server, which is a little bit more technically sophisticated in Web 110, that's fine too. As long as you're using one of the JCCC web servers to publish your work, I'm good with that. And of course, it's the basics. You need to be able to create folders, organize each project. By the time we get to Web 114 and Canvas, if you've had me in Web 110, things roll very similarly. If you're new to my classes, know that I try and do things in a very sequential way. So on the home link, each one of these modules will have a date on it so that you'll want to go through these items on that date. The first week, there are several things to do. Introduce yourself, look at the YouTubes and resources available for the class, read certain sections of javascript.info, and note that this is not only an instruction to read that, it's also a discussion thread. As you have questions or comments about the material you're reading, please post them here so that we can all benefit from the Q&A. And then I always provide just, you know, anything else going on. There's always ample opportunity for questions and comments. Ask questions early and often, particularly if this is your first programming language, because there's kind of a steep hill in the beginning. But once we get some of those basics down, a firm foundation will catapult you through this material. But you've got to get that firm foundation started. So do not ever hesitate to ask a question, either on the discussion threads or with me in email. You'll know what things are graded by the number of points beside the link. So there's a quiz one due on 3/5/20. That comes from a random pool of questions that I've collected over the years about that introductory material. They are untimed, they are open book, they are open computer. It's just that you only get one chance to take that quiz. So be prepared and do those readings and ask questions before you get into the quiz. And then the project one, which is very similar to how you did your projects in Web 110, it will be to key some sort of web page with some sort of JavaScript in it and to post that link to that assignment box. So thank you for listening. Welcome to the year 2020 and welcome to JavaScript 1. I can't wait to get started. Thank you.